Okay, well, if that wasn't spooky enough for you, we go from a walk through a haunted house and me getting very spooky to a chance for you to watch a bunch of classic monster movies. It is all happening at the Portland Film Festival this week, and we have a special guest at the festival giving us an inside look into the history of those creepy monsters. This is Jeff Pirtle. You are in charge of collection of movie history for NBC Universal. What exactly does that mean?
That's correct. So I'm director of the Archives and Collections Department. So we collect, preserve, maintain, exhibit all of the historic movie memorabilia, including props, costumes, vintage posters, photography, records, just anything and everything that has to do with the history of NBC Universal and our productions.
That's so crazy. And of course, there are so many classic monster movies
that come from
NBC Universal, right?
Yep. The classic monsters originated at Universal. They're definitely part of our studio's DNA. And we're really proud to be showing them here at the Portland Film Festival this week.
Yeah, for the film festival, every day they are screening monster movies. Tonight, which movie is screening tonight? Producer Christian, you just told me. Spanish Dracula. It's happening at 7:45. So if you finish watching our show, get into the total monster spirit, the Halloween spirit here, 7:45. You could still get there. So yeah, and all of these movies, they're the classic monster movies, but they've been digitally restored, right?
That's correct. Beginning in 2012, Universal embarked on a restoration initiative as part of the celebration of Universal Studios' 100th anniversary. And since that time, the studio's restored over 70 films. And they take a digital remastering of the original print, actually go frame by frame, cleaning up the film, and then create a new 35mm print. So what you're going to be seeing at the Portland Film Festival are these restored films that look crystal clear, high definition. They look great.
That's so cool, because a lot of people might have seen these monsters appear in newer movies today, but now they get to see like the original. You might think of Frankenstein, or
right.
Frankenstein's monster is really what we should call him.
Correct.
Right?
Yes,
you might have seen that.
Monster.
You might have seen Dracula. All these different things, but now they get to see the originals.
These are the originals. These were created at Universal Studios. There was a makeup artist there named Jack Pierce who created all of these monster creations that have become timeless. And so when you think of Frankenstein, it's that Frankenstein, Boris Karloff from the original film.
And there's Bride of Frankenstein, right?
There's Bride of Frankenstein right there, Elsa Lanchester.
What did you see? So you just got me, you got to see me turn into some type of creepy monster.
Right.
At a haunted house at the Beneath. What would you say?
Uh-huh.
That is like, is it a zombie? Is it a Frankenstein type thing? Like what?
Well, Frankenstein was actually a dead person that was brought back to life and kind of pieced together. I think you were more of a zombie in your Halloween experience. So the Bride of Frankenstein was actually created and brought back from the dead to be Frankenstein's monster's bride.
Oh gosh, I'm getting spooked out. We've got this like spooky music playing. It is all great. Do you have a personal favorite movie monster, classic movie monster?
So if I had to pick one favorite movie monster, I think I have to go with Frankenstein and Frankenstein's monster, just because it was such a classic tale and there's so much to learn from that and life lessons. And you know, these monsters, all they really wanted was to be loved. However, society looked at them like they were oddballs, you know, outsiders, but in reality, they just wanted to be accepted. So Frankenstein's monster really lives up to all of that billing, you know?
Okay, now I feel like I am Frankenstein's monster, just like described my life. Everyone just thinks I'm weird. I just want to. If people only have time to go to one of these screenings at the Portland Film Festival this week,
mm-hmm.
I mean, hopefully they can go to all of them. But
right.
Like if they were gonna see the epic, like perfect representation of classic NBC Universal classic monster movies, which one would you say?
Yeah, I believe House of Frankenstein will be screening.
Ooh.
And that's sort of a compilation of all of the different Universal monsters all into one film. So I'd recommend going and see that one.
When you are archiving and looking at all these things of all these movies
mm-hmm.
that have been created, what's been the craziest thing that you've discovered or gotten to see that the rest of us don't get to see?
So one of my favorite pieces in our collection is an original exhibitor's campaign book from the 1931 Dracula starring Bela Lugosi. So when you open that, you get a real insight into how movies were marketed back then. And Dracula was actually marketed as a romance. It opened on Valentine's Day, 1931.
How romantic.
It was the strangest passion the world had ever known. So that's probably you know, one of the pieces in our collection that not many people know about and really gives an insight into how these classic monster movies were originally marketed.
Wow, oh my gosh. Well, I feel inspired. Obviously, we are still in the Halloween monster spirit here. So we want our people at home, I don't know if you've seen us doing this week, Jeff, but we've been having our viewers help me pick my Halloween costume. So on Monday, they decided I'd have a purple wig. Last night, they decided it would involve a squid. And tonight, we have movie monsters. So the options are vampire, zombie, Frankenstein's monster, werewolf, or mummy. We will reveal your picks at the end of the show. Which one do you think I should go with?
Werewolf.
I mean, they would all be difficult. I don't know how to turn myself into any of them. But again, go to kgw.com/vote right now or pull up your KGW app and pick whichever one you think. Well, thank you so much, Jeff. Welcome to Portland.
You bet, Cassidy. It's great to be here.
Go check out all the movies at the Portland Film Festival all week.